Welcome back to another episode of Engineering Today, and I hope you're all having a great time. Now, Elon Musk recently talked about why he decided not to add stainless steel dragon wings to the Starship spacecraft. The decision happened 5 years after he first mentioned the idea on social media. Back in 2019, Musk posted on Twitter about the possibility of adding these large wings to Starship. The comment came right after the final season of Game of Thrones aired, which got people wondering if Musk was joking. However, Musk later explained that he was about 6.5 out of 10 serious about the idea and believed that it could work based on physics. Recently, Musk revisited this idea and mentioned that while it could technically work, the wings would add too much weight and complexity to the spacecraft. He responded to a user who asked if he thought more about the idea since he first talked about it 5 years ago. This decision is important because Musk often draws inspiration from movies and TV shows for the designs of his products. For example, he mentioned in an interview with Joe Rogan that the pointy design of the Starship was inspired by a movie called The Dictator, even though it might not be the best aerodynamically. Similarly, the Cybertruck made by Tesla is influenced by the movie Blade Runner. And in the meantime, our brilliant space enthusiasts, the Ring Watchers, are cooking up some incredible theories. They recently uncovered some exciting details about SpaceX's upcoming Starship version 2. This major revision promises significant improvements and will break down what we know in simple terms. According to the Ring Watchers, Elon Musk announced on Twitter that version 2 of Starship will have more propellant capacity, reduced dry mass, and improved reliability. These changes are crucial for enhancing the spacecraft's performance. One key aspect of SpaceX's approach is iterative development. This means they constantly refine and upgrade their designs based on testing and feedback. As part of this process, older versions sometimes get scrapped in favor of newer, better versions. For example, several Starship iterations were skipped to transition to version 2. Recent developments include the disposal of hardware related to version 2. Nose cones underwent significant changes, SpaceX cleared out older nose cones and introduced new designs with improved features like redesigned liquid oxygen header tanks for better fluid management. They also mentioned the introduction of Pathfinder hardware, which helps test new components and production processes. This includes redesigned payload bay sections with denser internal stringers and updated designs for heat tiles. On the other hand, SpaceX recently shared a video showing a Raptor engine slowing down during a test fire. The engine's nozzle is designed for Starship's use in space, so when it operates at lower pressures, you can see rings in the exhaust. SpaceX has been in the space business for more than 20 years. At first, it was a small company that often struggled to survive. But now it's a big player, constantly breaking records and changing how space launches work. SpaceX's success has also inspired other companies like Rocket Lab. Peter Beck, Rocket Lab CEO, credits SpaceX for showing that space can be commercial and worth investing in. He thinks the key to competing against SpaceX is to be smart and hardworking, like a mosquito that's annoying but can still pack a punch. Bill Weber, CEO of Firefly Aerospace, agrees that SpaceX is a tough competitor. He thinks there's still room for companies like Firefly in the market, especially for launching small and medium-sized satellites. Despite SpaceX's dominance, there are concerns about unfair competition. SpaceX's aggressive pricing and launch strategies have made it challenging for smaller players like Rocket Lab. However, Beck sees competition as a positive force and believes monopolies never last. Recently, SpaceX did a mission called Bandwagon that got a lot of attention. Some people in the space industry were worried because SpaceX charged very little money for this mission. For a long time, people thought Blue Origin, owned by Jeff Bezos, would compete strongly with SpaceX, but it hasn't done as well as people had hoped. SpaceX even beat Blue Origin for a big contract with NASA. However, Blue Origin is planning to launch a big rocket called New Glenn soon. If everything goes well, it could become a major player in space launches, especially for the military. Speaking of military, SpaceX has been launching more rockets from a military base in Santa Barbara County, which has caused some concerns. They wanted to increase their launches from 6 to 36 per year and also land rockets at another spot. These launches are impressive to see from far away, but they can disrupt life nearby. The noise and vibrations can be bothersome for residents and even force beaches and campsites to close temporarily. The California Coastal Commission discussed these plans and heard from people worried about the increase in launches. Residents and the commission are worried about the impact on the area, especially with more launches expected in the future. SpaceX has proposed some solutions, like installing internet terminals at a beach to notify visitors and providing shuttles during evacuations. But the overall increase in launches from SpaceX and other companies working with the military is still a concern. Now, coming to another news related to the concern, NASA has confirmed that the object that crashed into Alejandro Otero's home in Naples, Florida, came from the International Space Station. It was part of a cargo pallet carrying 5,800 pounds of batteries from March 2021. And it's made of a metallic alloy called Inconel, weighing 1.6 pounds and measuring 4 inches high and 1.6 inches wide. The batteries were discarded after new lithium-ion ones were sent to the ISS for an upgrade. Despite expectations that the pallet and batteries would burn up in the atmosphere, this didn't happen, prompting NASA to investigate further. They'll be looking into why the debris survived re-entry and updating their analysis models accordingly. This incident highlights the amount of space junk orbiting Earth, with thousands of pieces larger than 4 inches and millions of smaller ones posing risks to satellites and spacecraft. This reminds us of the dangers of space debris, especially considering the high speeds at which they travel. Some debris, like China's Long March 5B rocket stages, regularly falls back to Earth in an uncontrolled manner. And lastly, let's have a look into some very interesting news from the cosmos. A big black hole has been found close to Earth in our Milky Way galaxy. It was discovered using a European space telescope called Gaia. This telescope tracks the movements of billions of stars in our galaxy. The new black hole, called Gaia BH3, is 33 times heavier than our Sun. The most massive black hole found before this one in the Milky Way was in the Cygnus constellation and was about 20 times heavier than our Sun. Normally, black holes in our galaxy are around 10 times heavier than our Sun. Gaia BH3 is only 2,000 light-years away from Earth, making it the second closest black hole we found. The closest one, Gaia BH1, is 1,560 light-years away and is smaller than Gaia BH3. Although Gaia BH3 is big compared to stars, it's still much smaller than the supermassive black hole at the center of our galaxy called Sagittarius A. That black hole is 4.2 million times heavier than our Sun. All black holes have an outer boundary called an event horizon. This boundary is where the black hole's pull is so strong that not even light can escape. Black holes don't emit light themselves, but they can be seen when they pull in material from nearby stars, creating a bright glow and emitting X-rays. Sometimes black holes are in binary systems where they pull material from a companion star, forming a disk of gas and dust around them. The gravitational forces from the black hole make this material glow brightly. The discovery of Gaia BH3 was possible because it causes its companion star to wobble in its orbit. This wobble can be seen by astronomers like a dance in space. Gaia's precise measurements help scientists find this wobble and discover the hidden black hole. This discovery is just the beginning. Scientists expect to find more hidden black holes with Gaia's help, giving us a better understanding of these mysterious objects in our galaxy. And that's all for now. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting. And kindly provide your valuable feedback in the comment section. This will help us to improve.